Welcome back to the channel, everyone. I'm Indy, and today we're going to review Death's Door. Have you ever wanted to be a crow? Perhaps a reaper? Now you can be both. Death's Door opens up with you, a crow, heading to your job, what just so happens to be reaping souls. Upon arriving at work, you are given an assignment and instructed to complete the task as quickly as possible. That's because the longer you stay out, the older you get. Sounds simple enough, right? Well, this finds you fighting a boss fight within minutes of the opening scene. It's more of a tutorial and introduction to the game. Unfortunately for you and your crow, this is where things take a turn. No spoilers, but let's just say you won't be making it home in time for dinner. Death's Door does start off rather quickly. You are thrust right into combat and given your purpose so fast you might think the game will be over before you know it. This is not the case. However, you are given a task to complete and in which direction to head. The thing is, there are a ton of obstacles in your way. For the most part, fighting enemies in the beginning is pretty simple. Attack with your sword or shoot with your arrow. Ranged attacks can be done 4 times in a row before you have to basically reload, if you will. The only way to do that, though, is by hitting an enemy or by destroying around you stuff like boxes, mushrooms, and so on. Of course, dodging away from attacks is useful to land a perfect counter strike, but you also have a heavy attack that you can use, but I didn't take advantage of that much. I really enjoyed this style of combat, as for the most part, it felt fluid and natural to the game. The best part is you can upgrade as well. After defeating enemies, you collect their soul and can use them to purchase better melee damage or quicker attacks. They get a little pricey as you go along, so fighting enemies in the game is definitely rewarded. Death's Door isn't all about the combat though. There are puzzles to figure out, which, by the way, are not really all that complicated. I loved them though. Simple, precise, and sometimes required you to be quick on the trigger. Some will not be so obvious in the beginning because you probably don't have what you need, but no worries, as you can come back to those areas at any point in the game. That is, if you're near a door. See, you can travel to pretty much any area you want through doors. You just have to unlock said door first. You can find them at the beginning of most areas and, of course, right before something serious is about to go down, so you know when you see the door. If you're a gamer that enjoys completing everything, then just know you will need to do a ton of searching. You're already going to be searching as it is, but some things are hidden pretty well. There are several different weapons you can discover, but again, you will have to search for them. Same goes for like the little treasure items that you find throughout the game. You'll be able to unlock more range attacks, but that will come as you progress. While Death's Door plays pretty smooth with no real frame rate issues and such, I did notice a slight lag at times with the controls. I didn't know if it was just a one-off, but it did hurt during boss fights. Now, boss fights are certainly a highlight here. There are the big bosses in the game that you fight, but you also run into a few like mini bosses spread out through the game as well. While they do present a challenge, it's nothing that will cause rage-inducing fits. That is until the last boss. I won't go into detail about it, but it was incredibly difficult and lengthy. At times, I had flashbacks of the old Final Fantasy days while fighting that boss. No joke, it was the first time I had ever thought about just giving up. And honestly, that really sucked because I thoroughly enjoyed the other boss fights. There are plenty of great things to say about Death's Door. I said it a while back that I thought the game would exceed expectations with gamers. I don't think I was wrong. The game gives you this sense of being a lethal weapon. You are the Deathbringer, and those in your way will meet their demise. It isn't all dark, even though most of the game appears that way. There is some humor mixed in. The area designs are phenomenal, and the enemy variety sets the stage for each new location. Of course, setting the mood comes in the form of music, which can be downright stunning, sensational, and dare I say it, magnificent. Seriously though, the music sets the tone for this game. Everything from the story to the combat to the boss fights mesh into this almost perfect little package. Yes, there was a few things that worried me. The controls not having that crisp, responsive feel at times frustrated me, but that led to my biggest issue, and that was the last boss fight. It's long, way too long and very difficult. You need to be on point almost to perfection during that fight. However, it's a small gripe in what is a stellar game. In all honesty, and this is going to be not liked, but I prefer Death's Door over Hades. Thank you so much for watching, everyone. If you liked this video, please give it a thumbs up. I enjoyed this game very much. And I just wanted to add one little tidbit that you can heal yourself in the game by finding seeds and planting them in the pots. I know I showed it in the video, but I didn't mention it. But that was one of the things that kind of drove me a little crazy about the last boss fight, is it's so long and there's nowhere to heal yourself. It's very tricky and it's very tough. But other than that, I absolutely loved this game. This was a great game. And it moved way up on my list of favorite games this year so far. So if you enjoyed the video, please give it a big thumbs up. Maybe think about subscribing if you want to. And, well, as always, indie on, brah.